zombies, Batman couldn't believe what he was seeing and confronting as the dead rose from the grave to attack him. They were attacking from every angle, no breathing space for him. As much as the Batman tried to fight back by fighting them off him, the more overwhelming the zombies became, and they were coming for the kill. In truth, the Batman found out that the zombies were not real, but were robots made out of dead military bodies. As the Batman was fighting the zombies, he realized that one of the zombies was an imposter and possibly one of Riddler's henchmen disguising as a zombie. Close by was the Riddler and his henchmen in a van observing Batman and the zombies, which made the Riddler excited and joyful. Now, one of his henchmen was beginning to question the Riddler's sanity, for he thought the whole point was to get rid of the Batman. But it seems his boss had other objectives, which he is not disclosing. At this point, Batman was fighting tooth and nail with the robotic zombies, breaking them down to pieces, and kept an eye out for the imposter. Then he got wind of the imposter, who was disguising as one of the zombies, chased after him. As he was about getting close to the imposter, the Riddler, in fear of not wanting the Batman to know his future plans, pressed a device which triggered an explosive attached to the imposter, and he died, which made one of his henchmen object to his actions, but the Riddler threatened him to stand down, for he knows what he is doing. The Batman was shocked that the Riddler killed one of his own henchmen. It was confusing. As he leaped and jumped on the van Riddler was in, the driver of the van stepped on the brakes, shockingly, which flung Batman to the floor. And as the henchman tried to run him over, the Riddler held the steering of the van and diverted it away from Batman, who initially took a dive but saw what the Riddler did. But why? And this was the same question that had been revolving in the head of his henchmen. Among the broken robotic zombies and a blown up zombie imposter, Batman found another baby near the grave and a riddle carved in stone, which states, "You will find another little tot at the 25th who was shot." As Thomas Jefferson was trying to leave the basement, they could feel the demon's presence, and now they could not control Barbatos due to the fact that they did not complete the sacrifice. At this point in time, the girl, the human bat, was still comatose and drugged. They were filled with unadulterated fear, for they know they have beaten more they can chew because of their lust for power. With luck, they came out of the basement, leaving the demon and the girl behind. Then they closed and blocked the entrance of the basement with the support of black magic. In fear for his life, Jacob Stockman left and resided in Canada and never to return, having the knowledge that they locked an innocent girl in the basement with no chance of coming out. She screamed for help. She cried for help. She shouted for help, but no one came to her aid. So she was left in the basement to die alone. Still trying to decipher and solve the Riddler's riddle, Bruce Wayne fell asleep, which propelled him to a nightmare of how his parents were murdered in his presence. When he was a little boy, the loud scream of his mother woke him up. In truth, this nightmare instinctively triggered clues to the Riddler's location, in which coincidentally was close to where his parents were killed. The question that rippled his mind was if the Riddler knows his identity as the Batman, for this riddle was too close to home, but he wasn't taking any chances. In preparation for the arrival of the Batman, one of Riddler's henchmen wanted to know if this time they were going to get rid of the Batman once and for all. And the Riddler replied him when the time is right. And the Riddler also asked one of his other henchmen to get him ping pong balls and make sure that they are the right accurate circumference in measurement for his next move. For there is no place for errors. When Batman got to the location of where he thinks the Riddler was situated, at a bar, he asked one of the customers, who was a police officer off duty, if he noticed anything unusual. Before he could get an answer, a van smashed and crashed into the bar, and as the back of the van swung open, vicious Rottweiler dogs sprung out on a vicious attack on the customers, including Batman. Lucky enough for the policeman off duty, he brought out his gun with him and began to shoot at the vicious dogs. As one of the dogs jumped and attacked the Batman from nowhere, someone passed him a silver dagger and he used the dagger to stab the dog in the abdomen and it fell to its death. To the Batman's amazement, he saw the bartender of the bar running away towards the van and wondered why he gave him a silver dagger as he ran after the moving van, thinking the bartender was driving, but was met with a surprise, realizing that the van was being driven by remote control. The bartender was nowhere to be found, as the van was taking him to an unknown location, which stopped by a drainage that led downwards, in which he carefully followed but was met with a bright light which blinded his vision as Riddler's henchmen lay into him, hitting him with baseball bats continuously. But the Batman defended himself by going on the offensive and in knocking Riddler's henchmen out cold. Confronting the Riddler from a distance, who was standing next to the kidnapped baby in a pram, he let Batman understand that he had pushed down a ping pong ball down the throat of the baby and that the baby was going to die due to choking. That if he doesn't try to save the baby will die. And Batman was left with an impossible choice.